Good morning.
From the pastor
and first lady
of the Friendship Baptist Church in Hamilton, Georgia, we want to welcome you this morning to our Sunday morning broadcast.
We really hope that there's a song, prayer, a word spoken that will truly bless your life.
So please join our services now, already in progress.
Know that it was the grace of God. for anybody who's anybody who would declare there is no God. I want to declare, meet the God that I serve, who has angels that watch over you. The old church would say all through the night, and I can testify now, all through the day, the angels kept watch over me. I'm here today because I couldn't sit at my house after what God has done for me. I'm here today because I want to give God praises for what God has done in my life. I'm here today because I know it wasn't me, nor my driving, nor nothing. But I'm here today simply because of not just grace, but God's amazing grace. I wish I had about 10 of y'all in here who ain't scared, who ain't ashamed to tell the Lord thank you for what God has done, what God is doing. And how many of y'all know by faith what God is able? I'm a living witness. God is still good. I'm a witness. He's blessing right now in what I thought was to be a usual busy Saturday morning. Saturday day, we had basketball games, had two basketball games, we had two softball practices, had a funeral scheduled. And so what I told Sister Day, I got up about 6:30 and said, listen, let me go ahead now and get Dillon a haircut, because I know after the funeral, we got to get softball practice and let Alexis throw around a little bit. Doctor has released her provisionally, and she wanted to throw with the team. So I said, we'll talk, knock that out. So we got up, got Dillon dressed, washed his face, kind of got him together. And we hopped in our car, and we was on our way. And it was the Spirit of God. I just want to suggest to somebody, whenever the Spirit of Christ speaks to you, you ought to listen. I wish I had a witness in here. Whenever the Spirit of Christ speaks to you, you ought to listen. Because when I got off of Warm Springs Road, I made a left on Solomon Road. Those of you who are familiar with the Columbus area, and I was headed across J.R. Allen Parkway on 2 Macon Road. But all while when I turned on Solomon Road, the Spirit of Christ said, you should have just went straight down Manchester Expressway and then made the left to get on J.R. Allen Parkway. But I said, I'm here now. I'm just going to go on so we can get through with this and move on and do what we need to do. I came to the first stop, which was there at the corner of Solomon Road and J.R. Allen Parkway. Stop, and I did stop. After I proceeded to the medium, I looked left and right, and I did not see any vehicle. When I pressed my gas to go across the medium to the other side, the next thing I knew was that I had been hit, and my eyes were awakened, and I looked back, and Dillon was covered in glass. I jumped out of my car. At that point, this is how good God is. Dillon was unresponsive to me. I called his name. He would not answer. I called I grabbed him and pulled him out, and I couldn't do nothing but lay him on the ground. There was a lady from Bat Valley, Alabama, who jumped out of her car, and she came to where we were. And she just said, sir, just lay him, leave him here. Just leave him here. Don't move him, because at that point, we didn't know if his neck was broken, or we didn't know what was going on, or whether he was alive or dead. And so at that moment, I stopped what I did, and all I could do was pray. All I could do, I didn't have time for a long prayer. I just left and said, Lord, have mercy right now. Just have mercy right now. And before long, maybe about 2 to 3 minutes later, she said it was about 3 to 4 minutes later, he began to cough. And all I could do was say, thank you, Jesus. Can't nobody tell me, ain't no secret to what God can do. What he's done for others, I thank God he's able to do for me and you. Amen. And so it is here, my testimony of the goodness and the splendor of God's amazing grace is that while we should have been dead, Somebody in here missed what I just said. I said, while Alexis and Anaya ought not have a daddy and sister, they ought not have a husband. While we should have been dead, God said, not today. I wish I had some people in the building today who will give testimony that you still serve a God. That ain't nothing gonna happen. Y'all gonna help me in here. I yell because ain't nothing gonna happen. Winds may blow, breakers may dance, but ain't nothing gonna happen until the Lord is ready. Ain't anybody glad he's able? I said, is there anybody glad he's able? Anybody glad you got hands to wave, eyes to see, legs to walk on, a tongue to talk? You ought to not worry about who's saying something about you. If I had some real saints with a real testimony in a real place, you ought to help me tell God thank you, because you know he's worthy. Anybody know God is worthy? Hallelujah. 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 I give him praises. I give him praises. For he said, not today. Can I just, I'm going to move out the way, you won't hear from me again, but can I just give testimony as to the realness of God's grace? Those of you who know, in the month of February, I'm doing Pastor's Corner on WEAM 107, and try this Pastor's Corner. Those who heard it, it was entitled, Covered by the Blood. I texted Pam yesterday and said, Pam, today's event was a testimony, was a manifestation of yesterday's Pastor's Corner, because Peter said, without a shadow of a doubt, the saints of God, the people of God, have been indeed covered by his blood. Do I have a witness in here? There was, first of all, promise of the Savior. There was power to the sinner. But I thank God there was protection to the same individual. And I want to suggest, whenever you've been covered by God's blood, not some things, not a few things, but how many of y'all know everything, it'll be all right. Do I have a witness? So in summation today, don't take now for granted. Don't take today for granted. Don't put off today for tomorrow, because tomorrow is not promised. Do I have a witness in here? If you mad at somebody, you better get your madness right. If you upset with somebody, you better get your upsetness right. Because when I lay cross this altar, I want to go from here to there with the notion that I've been a child of the King. Do I have a witness in here? Don't call me Alexis Lanaya Dillon's daddy. Don't call me Sister Day's husband. Don't call me friendship pastor. But I want the Lord to call me servant. Well done. You've been faithful over a few things. Come high and I'll make you rule over me. Amen. Just give the Lord one big hand of praise. Just give the Lord one big God bless you. Give the Lord just one thank you, one hallelujah. Just praise him from whom all blessings flow.
Pastor Day, if I may, I just got to say this. We were laying and Dillon's in our bed, and we were talking this morning, and we were thanking God for what he's done. And Pastor Day, he said to Dillon, he said, Dillon, you saved my life yesterday. Dillon looked up, he said, no, Daddy, it was God. God protected us. So I'm thankful that at 5 years old, he knows it was God that protected him. Hallelujah. And Pastor Day, when he got up, I know he's trying to act like nothing's wrong, but he said, I'm sore. I can't hardly move. I'm real sore right now. And I thought about it, and I said, babe, I'm sorry that you're sore. But I said, it's a sign that you are alive today.
Hallelujah.
You can feel the pain.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry you feel it, but I'm glad you feel it at the same time. So you got to excuse me, but I got to give God glory. Got to give God glory. Yeah.
Come on, wherever you are, come on, let's pray together. Come on, the altars.
Hallelujah.
are extended. We're making ready to pray. We want to pray. And we want to get ready to hear what God has to say based upon what he's already said. Those who want to share.
Even when I didn't deserve it, Lord, you made a way. Lord, you made a way. When the situation seemed impossible, you
share this with you as we're praying, as we're holding hands in hand. Let me just suggest to somebody, this is not just an isolated event for Pastor Day and Dillon, but just this week, Kim's daughter, Melvin's granddaughter, was in a horrific wreck as well, and she had to be cut out. And the testimony is that she's able to tell the story. I want to tell you, he's not just making waves for me. He's making waves for you. He's not just making waves for you, but he's making waves for the person you're standing next to. And don't you tell me God won't fix it. I can call the roll. Brittany, if she was here, Tita, she'll tell you he made a way. Do I have a witness in here? Reading the article the other day, I can tell you God will fix it. He'll do it one more time. These are not the only events, but some of y'all in here know that we've been through some days where we didn't know we were going to make it out. But God did it again. You got your own testimony. You got your own remembrance. And if you go on and give God what he's deserving of while you're in the valley, your testimony will be he will bring you through. Come on, let's bow our heads in prayer. Our Father and our God, Father of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the one who rules and super rules both heaven and earth, God of all grace, Master, we come this morning simply to say, Lord, we thank you. God, we want to pause here now to just say thank you for life as well as it is. For God, we understand it did not have to be this way, but Lord, I thank you. You look beyond our faults. And God, even this morning, you're supplying all of our every needs. Father, we come to you this morning. God, we don't come as an outside show to a dying world, but we come again as an empty pitcher before a full fountain. Father in heaven, we come asking right now, if it would be your will, God, to simply have thine own way. God, we need you this morning to have your way in this place. God, have your way from the choir stand all the way to the back door. God, have your way. God, that we might recognize that you are God and God all by yourself. God, we come today, God, with different issues. We come today with different personalities, with different problems. But God, we come because we know that whatever we need, we can find it in the palm of your hand. God, somebody around the altar, God, don't know how they're going to make it. Somebody don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. But God, I come today thanking you. You've got tomorrow in the palm of your hand. God, we come this morning not because we are coming out of formality, but we come, God, to give you glory. God, we couldn't just sit there where we were, God, but we had to make our way to the house of the Lord one more time. For God, you've been good to us. God, you've been better to us than we've been to our own self. God, you brought us a mighty long way. God, you brought us, God, even when we couldn't bring ourselves. God, you loved us even when we were unlovable and didn't love ourselves. God, you are steadily doing again for us what we can't do for ourselves. God, we come this morning to say thank you. God, we just thank you today even for the aches and pains in our body. We thank you today even for the soreness of our body. God, we just thank you, God. You've given us another chance to iron out one wrinkle and wipe down another spot. God, we thank you. Don't know how, God, but you did it. God, don't know how, but you need it, God. Don't know why, but you did it. And for that, we say thank you. Thank you for your blood, God. Thank you for keeping us. Thank you for covering us. Thank you for protecting us, God. Thank you. For Father, we hand you down and talk. We couldn't say thank you enough. But God, we come to simply say thank you. Thank you because, God, you again allowed our golden moments to roll on a little while longer. God, we come to simply say thank you. Thank you again, God, because you look beyond our extremity. And God, you provided us an opportunity. And God, for that we come to say thank you. God, we thank you today not just simply because it's Sunday, but God, we thank you for yet another day's journey. And God, here we are standing around your altar, having our hands locked one another. God, thank you because you're so good. God, you've been better to us than we've been to our own self. God, you've been better to us, God, even when we thought about being to our own self. God, we thank you today for yet again grace and mercy. Thank you for grace and mercy, God, that again followed us from our home to our destination. Thank you for grace and mercy that allowed us to get back from our destination to our home. And God, for that, we say we thank you. God, we pray for every person who's under the sound of my voice. We pray for every home, every heart today. We pray, God, that you would just simply make us one body in Christ. God, we want you to do what you've done so many times before. Show us how good you really are. Sickness in our bodies, heal our bodies. Hearts broken, mend our hearts. Minds unstable, regulate our minds. God, turn us from where we are going to where you would have us to be. For God, we say, ride on, King Jesus. Ride on, King Emmanuel. For God, if we know that if you ride, everything will be all right. And God, we come this morning simply to say thank you. God, we had another tongue. We couldn't say thank you enough. But God, thank you for doing for us what we can't do for ourselves. God, we thank you for Jesus, your only begotten Son. God, thank you for giving him as a ransom to our life. Thank you, God, for him coming down through 40 and 2 generations. Thank you, God, for him marching from a judgment hall to judgment hall. Thank you, God, for him lifting up on that cross. Thank you, God, for him being speared in his side. Blood came down for my redemption. Water for my baptism. Lord, I thank him because he's not like any other Christ. Thank you. He died on a hill called Calvary. But I'm shouting today because he didn't stay dead. Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand, and I thank you for his saving power. I thank you for his amazing power. I thank you for his covering power. You brought us a mighty long way, and we fall now to say thank you. Thank you for you've been good. Thank you for you've been worthy. God, you're worthy. not just my house, but thank you for keeping the next house, and the next house, and the next house. But now, God, we want to hear from you. Need a word from on high. Give us a word, God, that will be strength to our bodies. Give us a word, God, that will help us to run on a little while longer. We need you, God. We need to hear from you. Speak, God, as only you can speak. Hide the preach man beneath the cross. Hide him that these, your people, will see none of him, but that they will see all of thee. God, we bless your name. We bless your name, God. Out of all we've been through, we bless your name. Because we still have joy. God, thank you. The joy we have, the world didn't give it. And I'm grateful this morning. The world cannot take it away. Speak now from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Speak, God, that when we leave this place, but never from your presence, we will say it was good to be together one more time. Not in my name we pray. Not in any of these parishioners' names we pray. Not in the preacher's name we pray. In the name of Mary's baby, Joseph's stepson, in the name that he that said, if I lay down my life, in 3 days I'll pick it up again. In Jesus' name we pray. Yeshua Messiah, Jesus the Christ, we pray. Every heart that agrees said, amen, amen, amen. Hug you someone next to you and you tell them God loves you, and so do I.
And all the people of God said, amen. First Lady Arnethia Day and myself, we would like to say thank you so very much for listening and tuning in to our morning broadcast.
Here at Friendship Baptist Church, we are a family of love, united in the power of Christ. And we invite you to join us in the beautiful city of Hamilton for worship, live and in person.
Listen, we're located at 101 Friendship Street, Hamilton, Georgia, the heart of Harris County, where we're looking for you to be a part of us.
And remember, as Pastor Day always says, we're not smiling on God, but God is smiling on us.